Okay, we're heading to Faro. So we left Monte Gordon yesterday after a 350 mile ride from, I can't quite remember where we were, but we went to Granada. Oh yeah, Valencia. Okay, so that was quite nice. So now we just got Faro plugged in. We were going to go a little bit further into the Algarve, but someone recommended that rather than Albufeira, go to Faro. It's a bit of an old town, you know, it's got a bit more character and that kind of stuff. So we'll go out here and have a look. Yeah, the plan is that we'll chill out near the beach, get a bit of rest. Because for the next 5 days, 6 days, we'll be heading back. I'm not using indicators, do they? That is BMW drivers. Lovely day, as you can see. This is us leaving Faro in the morning. Beautiful day yesterday. It's been raining most of the night. And we're now on our way to the Gurdwara in Albufeira. Yeah, okay. All dressed up in hot, cool weather gear. Okay. Had a nice little breakfast. We bought some food yesterday. So we had a nice little breakfast this morning. Had a bit of coffee, so we've had time to pack a nose because there was nothing at this. I mean, although it was a very nice place, the heater didn't work, the toaster was a bit, you know, it wasn't that nice, to be honest. Mind you, we didn't pay top dollar or anything, but nevertheless, I think they could have done a bit more for, you know, L50 quid. They could have made it a little bit nicer. We sat on the bike for half an hour and my back's really hurting today. That's not happened before. Try and touch all the potholes, try and dodge all the white lines and the river crossing. Where is it? Is it here? I can't see the Nishan family there. Alright, we just left the Gurdwara. Had a nice bit of curry sauce, chole. Food was absolutely lovely. And a little chinwag with the guys. Jazz has exchanged a few numbers. So never know, might see a few of them turn up in the UK. On the foggy, my foggy is the wrong position. Pulling the nose now. We need to get the R up in there, mate. And I have to adjust that a bit later on, whenever that is now. So now we were going to go to Tunic, I'm sorry, the motorway route. But the weather seems to have cleared up a bit. That's it, now we're going to try the Tunic route. Which has been quite valid. So when we see something worth seeing, I'll switch it in there. Okay. Decided to not go the motorway route, but we went to the Mother's Road. It's just a single road. Absolutely rural places and absolute villages. Nobody else on the road. It's the park to be taken. It runs a bit poorly at times. So far, so far, I've been dreading that when it goes to my travel pit. Oh, okay. Okay, so we've got probably no sense of this view. We've got a little natural one to work. Had enough of these little roads. Seen a bit of rural Portugal. Trying to jump on a bit of motorway, make some headway. This is all lovely to see these little roads, but they haven't been taking it very quick. They seem to twist and turn all the way. So you're not doing a lot of mileage.
Here we are, past Beja, whatever it's called. Heading north of Portugal.
Say properly.
North.
Beja.
Yeah, so we're heading up there. We're heading north. Jazz is having ice creams again.
Yeah. Well,
buy me one as well. I didn't even ask for one.
No, I'm sure you didn't.
Somehow insistent I have these magnums.
As they say in Punjabi,
there you go. No one knows what he's talking about.
Freaking honky.
He just makes it up as it goes along. And look what he's got. A Solero. They didn't get me a Solero, they didn't notice that. Got me
you
this.
You wanted an almond.
Right.
Chocolate almond.
Didn't say to me, I'm going to get a Solero.
I saw the option and I took it. Fortune favours the brave. He who dares wins. You snooze, you lose.
Yeah, hope it tastes like shit.
Oh, it's fucking lovely. It's like that mango sorbet thing we had yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Orange.
Chocolate orange. Tastes almost like that.
Very good. Right. So yeah, we went to the Gurdwara today. I'm getting tired. Went to the Gurdwara. I did a mantra take and had some lovely langar there. Came back with the boys. And it was raining. Full wets on. Cleared up actually, about half an hour out of Albufeira, wherever it's called. Then we went down some mad roads. It was alright though.
Fucking friend, wasn't it?
Yeah. Real rural.
I thought it was going to turn into a dirt track at one point.
Yeah, so they were. Real rural Portugal. I got a fair amount of footage of that. And now. Oh, damn. Now we're, like I said, past Beja. And we're going to make some more headways. We've got plenty of time. If we can clock another 100 out.
Easy.
We've done 120 at the moment.
I've done 120.
Mm. But it's all that twisties and everything.
Twisties.
Yeah. So we'll bang out another 100 odd. And then we'll see where we are. And then we'll try and find a big town. Cheap hotel. Jazz is having a salad.
And an ice cream.
Third day, he's having a salad.
And an ice cream.
Yeah, so we'll show you where we end up. Bye.
Well, we've just come up this little road, beautiful road, and we've landed up here. But look at the scene. Nice bit of scenery. Just pulled us right up, so that road down there is the road that we sort of came up. I don't know, that looks like a bit of a dirt road, but the road we came up must be the first, it's almost similar. Logging road. Yeah, there's a couple of tight hairpins. Yeah, it's a few of the rain already. Also coming up the alley. Thank you. Okay, we're on our way to Gurdwara. We've gone past Beja. And it's about 56 kilometers away. Back to Gurdwara. So this is along with IGT-802 and part of the
still riding up north Portugal. We've ended up in this quaint little town here, mate. Yeah? We've no idea where it is. But it's got a waterfall there, isn't it? Yeah, done a lot of roads, seen a lot of construction, seen a massive. So we're in Elvas, I think. There's a little sign up there. Yeah, it's got big old historical buildings as well. It's got a massive viaduct. So yeah, we're gonna get some coffees from over there. Jazzy's trying to sort that out. And after we had that, I think we're gonna crack on and work out where we're gonna stay. But we might even stay around here somewhere. Looks all right. I think it's quite a decent size town, yeah, so I might have somewhere to stay rather than try and crack on and not be able to find anywhere. So I think we'll have to have a little look what's available around here. Right, check in a little bit later on. Don't know where Jazz has disappeared to. Must have gone to the loo, but left his bike keys on the table. Yeah, maybe we should hide them. That'd be funny, wouldn't it? We'll see.
Elvas, a little place called Elvas. Seems to have a lot going for it. There's a big fort at the top, so there's obviously a place they wanted to protect. Yeah. Look at that. That is beautiful, isn't it? That is some grand architecture there, mate. Okay. That is beautiful. Wow. Whoever built that, eh? They got money, didn't they? Look at that viaduct. That is impressive. Okay. So we booked a hotel in, I think it's called Borba. Yeah, he's got the directions. We're off to there. Got a waterproof back on. Looks like he's going to pop down in a minute. So, yeah. So we've got about 27 pence to do. Because we wanted an apartment. It's been in Borba town, it's still in Portugal rather than go to Spain, which was pretty much, you know, 30 odd kilometres in the other direction. So we could have gone there as well. We were very close to the border.
Just try this. It's fucking cold, eh?
Well, I had it on warm, yeah? I don't know what you just done to it, yeah?
Look, that's on fucking max 30, yeah? Full oscillation.
But hang on, it was working fine before you walked in here and messed it up, right?
How's it messed up?
Hang on.
When the thing don't work.
But wasn't it working fine when you walked in here?
It's probably that
was it nice and cozy
here? It's probably that fucking geezer left that heated shit. That's probably what you can smell.
Bro, it was working fine before coming here and messed it up with your dodgy remote control, which you swapped with mine already, by the way.
I'm going to put it on fucking icicles cold then. Hang on, let's see if that works. I'm putting it on.
You take the big bed. Yeah, you take the superior room as usual.
I'll put it on 16.
Yeah.
I'll put it on 4.
And now you're in here messing me up.
I'll put it on.
When will you be happy?
I'll put on air conditioning, 16. Full isolation, you're gonna be fucking.
I'm gonna be a fucking ice cube in the
morning. You're gonna be a fucking mucha butt in the morning. See, that, even that's not working. See, that's still blowing out the same sort of fucking air. What's the options? What does that mean?
Just do the mode, isn't it? There's only a couple of things.
I'm doing the mode, mate, and the mode ain't working, is it?
Well, the mode is heat. If you leave it there for 2 minutes.
Listen, you're just a delivery.
Huh?
Project manager, yeah?
Yeah.
I'm fucking IT operations, yeah?
Yeah.
Leave it to the man that fucking knows what to do, yeah? You're just a fucking...
Bro, you do know the conflict that operations
you're just,
and delivery
you're
have,
just
yeah?
A fucking pen
pusher. You're meant to operate what I deliver to you. Yeah, a delivery knows how it works. Operations, you just suss out how it works.
Yeah, you know, I'll give you the documentation then.
I don't need to.
See, you don't need it because you don't know what you're doing.
No, work it out.
I'm working it out.
Yeah, it's like me giving you a good deal. I ain't going to give you instructions how to drive
you're,
you should know how to drive
the delivery aspect is pointless. It's just an extra tier.
How can you say it's pointless?
Of pointlessness.
No. Without delivery, you wouldn't have innovation. You wouldn't have progress.
Pointless.
No, operations, you've got a lot of stuff
just,
that ain't working.
It's just a tier, irrelevant tier that's not required. That complicate the issue, then it's more complicated than it should be complicated.
All right, so why is this room getting colder when you got it at 30 degrees? Yeah. Have you got it at 30 degrees?
I think
icicles.
I think we have to blame the delivery of the said. Oh, it's kicking now. Look, I've just fixed it, mate. I've just fixed it. It's kicking.
Hang on, so I delivered it. And you worked out how to work it, and all of a sudden, I fixed it.
No,
that's not how it works, bro.
You delivered a faulty item.
I delivered it fully functioning.
Which I managed to fix.
With a remote control.
Anyway.
Yeah, you had to do it.
Got your work in.
All right, good.
I've got to get mine working.
There he goes into his superior room.
Oh, it's kicking.
All right.
It's kicking.
Everything's working, you happy bunny?
It's fucking hunky dory.
All right, good. Shukaraya.
Fucking hell. See, it takes a fucking IT operations person to make the thing work.
There he goes, there, yeah.
Alright, we stayed at this little quaint place yesterday. That was Jazzy's room. That was my room. It was all en suite. Kitchenette. Got a kitchen. Got a couple of cabins. Borba, I think, is the name of the town. But there you go. Yeah. Quite nice. We got here late yesterday. Right mission about parking the bike. As you can see, it's all gravel. But we managed to get here okay. Hopefully, get out Yesterday we did a couple of roads which were pretty dusty, so the bikes are pretty filthy. Probably need a, you know, look at that. Look at the lovely orange trees. And that's the main building over there where we ate. So might keep the glasses out. Got my drink. Keep the camera bag out. Pack the rest up. I'll have to charge my other phone. We need it. So I've got a phone with the Wi-Fi on it. I've got my phone, but now I'm going to use up the other phone's Wi-Fi because it's only for 30 days anyway. If I don't use it, I lose it. So I'm going to try and use it all up. Right, where are we heading today, Jazz?
East. West.
We're heading east, aren't we?
Yeah.
East. Yeah, we're heading east.
East.
Where are we going?
We can go west.
We go east. We go west. Not sure.
The time is ours.
We could go east-west. To the east coast, to the west. Right, we could do a bit of that. Right. Okay, put my camera way back in there just before we leave. I need to go and get my jacket. Yeah, this is the other phone. So I will keep that handy so that I can switch that on when I need it. Keep my iPhone charger handy. As Jazz nicks my plug every night. I can't charge anything, yeah? I just sit there aimlessly, waiting for him to return it, which he never does.
So hard done by him.
And this is the fact of touring with Mr. Danua. Right, gonna head towards Spain, basically. Going to the east from the west. Yeah, look, my phone's dead. Bloody hell. Better charge this phone first now.
When you charge it up last time?
Don't know, mate. I wonder why.
What's the matter with it?
As soon as we unpack, might need a charger.
Need a charger.
He's missing H. He needs a charger every night so he can talk to H. Catch up on the goss. Otherwise, then we need the neon. Huh?
You're the one who's a
lovesick
puppy. Showing pictures of your missus to everybody.
Good looking girl.
I miss my wife. Oh, I wish I was with her instead of
this here
ugly,
on tour
instead of this ugly gorilla.
There's some truth in that. No, let me go and get my jacket. So we just need to return the key. I've got my helmet.
It's all solid powder, isn't it? But
yeah.
Is that a water? That's a water thing, isn't it? Thank you.
Yeah, water, solar pad.
He's all self-sufficient, isn't he? I've got to whack it on.
What do you think it's going to rain? It was like this yesterday. Really odd looking sky, can't see anything. Looks foggy.
Might drizzle, you never know.
Ooh. Right, I'm gonna brave it.
Oh, you're such a hero.
I know. How do I do it? Hey? Not a lot of that left. Hey? Look at this. Look at these oranges. Look at that. Yeah? Look at these melons. I mean, yeah, really nice. All right, we're about to drive out. I'll might catch a bit of it on my camera. Let's see. Yeah, probably see you next in Spain.
Okay, so that's where we are in Portugal, and we need to get to, yeah, it looks good, IPV 1-2, yeah, very good. Right, you're leading, let's go to Spain. Look at the bike. The bike is filthy, look at all the dust on it. Look at my seat. Oh my god. Thought we had a bloody... some sort of dust cloud yesterday. There's some motorways there. But, oh god, look at this filth on the bike. Why is my bike so dirty? My dad's where driving on the right hand side of the road. Left, and you're off in the default in the mornings when you get on the bike. You have to get the wheel. Okay, let's do that. 225 miles done yesterday. $2,305 done in total. Zero that, it's Wednesday. Okay, we did about 40 kilometers. And about 42 now, so about 40 kilometers to go. We pass over the border into Spain. Quite interesting to find out on the map afterwards where the hell we went. Because we're just following the Garmin. And the Garmin is taking us physically. And no doubt about that. Okay, we're going
right, about 80 miles, but yeah, it's pretty much straightforward, hopefully.
I heard that town just a second ago that said we were passing through. This night is this massive villa here. Oh, it's a hotel. Wow, that's pretty nice. And then they've got one over there on top of the hill. Yeah. There's a modern part of it. No part. Looking very Portuguese there. Down to the middle of nowhere. That's down the city limits. Look at that. Look at the land is all from Norway up there. Look at that. Portugal. Okay, we're not going that way. And then we're going home. Okay. Yeah, sometimes I think it confuses how you got to look. Right. Roseanne. Okay, the town is Roseanne. Yeah, I've got somebody more. Chakravarti Tour. Is it? Chakravarti Tour. nice, isn't it? Disco pack! Saloon's wall, is this good, isn't it? Ah, really? But we're under 803 or on the way to the 803. Some nice little twisty roads here. I thought I'd try and record them. Trying to get the bike down to manual, I think. So, see what the gears are doing. Into automatic mode. Get me off the fingers. Things that sounds like this. What's up, bro? We're getting coffee. Okay. Yeah, yeah. We've done 103. 103. Yeah, we can have a little break there. You want to do that? Go on then.
All right, here we are. We're in Garo Villas, just about to leave it. There we go. We're gonna have a little drink, have a little chill out. Nice little town, isn't it? Done 100 miles already. It's about 2 o'clock, 10 to 2, I think. We left about 11:30, maybe quarter to 11:30, something like that. This morning. Here's the bikes. I have to find a kitty, otherwise apparently I have to pay for it. Some things don't change. Yeah, look how dirty the bikes are, man. Just look at that. I mean, this one was probably in this state when it arrived, but I'll show you my one, which was a lot cleaner.
I think you were.
Yeah, look at that.
I think you scraped my side, you did.
How did I scrape your side? Oh yeah, look at that. Huh? Look at that. Look at the cockpit, man. It's filthy. Filthy.
You've got some cleaning to do, mate.
Yeah, yeah. Not liking the bike that dirty. All right, we're going to have a cuppa. And then we'll, no doubt, catch you en route. Garo Villas, there you go.
Okay, we're doing a cup of coffee, 108 miles. Well, we had a cheeky baby shot, to be honest. And not good, but I think it's hot for the pool room. Yeah, and a hot cup of that. I thought I'd better take a bit of video through here. There's a weird, slightly different landscape. Alright, to make up for time, because we've been enjoying this little back street for far too long, I'm going to have to whack it on the motorway. To make some changes. Otherwise we haven't got a lot of telephone up and down today in order to get I wonder if there's anybody else in the country. It's like you're the only people, right?
Alright, here we are. Having the pinnies.
Oh, lovely.
On our way.
He's back again.
Oh, fuck.
He's on the right path this time, the fucker.
Alright. So that guy in the van, trying to get on the motorway from over there, and there's no entrance to the motorway, end up in a ditch. So we've done about 170 miles so far.
Have we?
Yeah. In total. State of my bike. 170. Trying to make some progress now because we're on the motorways, non-tolls. And we want to... Where are we going? I thought we were going to Salamanca. Heading in that direction. Man of mystery, where are we going?
Salamanca, Madrid way. And then rearing towards Andorra, top of Andorra.
There you go. To be honest, with all this mitty, everything's looking a bit naff. Yeah, a bit of a truck stop. No toilets. Well, there is a toilet. There you go.
It was lucky you wrapped the anchors on at the last minute.
Yeah, if he'd gone over, he'd have been, wouldn't it?
Could you bring a tow rope?
No, he mustn't. Oh, look, there's a skid mark. There's a skid mark, bro. He was going off here. You guys are gonna pull the chain? Come on! Once again, come on, show me how it's done.
Come on, mate, 250 kilos.
Ready?
Go!
That's it.
It's awful to see him suffer, wouldn't it? Don't mess about with that now. It looks a bit loose though, isn't it? Only half an inch.
It's alright.
Not that bad.
It should have 2 inches.
She said. Right. Just give it a deal, innit? So this is something we do routinely. Still can't get rid of my bike. Right, I'm gonna have to have a look on the map. See if there's anything worth seeing. Might have to put on a little bit of Google and see if there's any gorges or such like.
Gorges.
Gorges en route.
Watch it.
You're going to run the engine?
Yeah.
All right. How to oil your chain with the engine running? Let's just hope his bike doesn't go off in the same direction as the little van nearly did. All right, lovely jubbly. Have we done it? Should we kick the wheel?
We need to buy some more of this.
Are you finished? Karde khatam
hona hai. Yeah, but I might get one more out of it. No?
Why don't you just lob it on now and we'll get one at the service station?
I can't buy these at the service station.
No, it's petrol station. No?
I have to buy my motorbike shop.
Next time we see one, Honda.
There's loads.
Kawasaki.
Did you see that one?
Huh?
Did you see that one, Kawasaki, on the roof?
Think so.
You did, innit? That green shop.
Yeah.
Not big, but it was there, innit?
Yeah, I've seen quite a few on route.
Got one for like one more.
Alright, and now we're going to have a little look-see on the map. Where are we on the map anyway? What page are we on? Do we have a clue?
Yeah.
98. Sierra Nevada, 93. 96. 93, here we are, 93. So we were going, there's Lisboa, there's Badajoz. We went through here, Caracas. And we must be now, we were on the E803.
Heading towards around here, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
There were signs for that, wasn't there?
Yeah, Plancia, yeah.
And then Salamanca's up there, isn't it? Well, I think we need to head that way.
Really?
Yeah, because we're going across, not upwards, aren't we? Right. 94. There you go. We need to be heading sort of this way over. I think it's going to take us on top of Madrid.
Yeah, we want to go on this road, don't we? The 110. To Avila. There's Salamanca. Yeah. It's not miles out of our route.
And have you been there before?
Yeah, we went.
Yeah, we went to Salamanca before.
Yeah, I'm not saying we have to go there. I'm just saying in terms of a route.
It's heading towards Salamanca. We're on the E803 or E80.
Well, I think we're on 80, you know me.
So we're heading towards there.
Yeah, that's where we're heading. The road does go to Salamanca.
It might be selecting these because they're toll free.
Yeah.
That's why.
We will be all right. Check page 88. Check page 88. Okay, so we want to go to.
No, we're not going there. We're going to go over here.
Oh, are we going to go down a bit further down?
We're going down to Andorra, top of Andorra, aren't we?
All right. Okay. Yeah.
Which is 90.
All right.
Langar. So we're heading around there, aren't we? Remember?
All right.
Unless you want to go that way.
No, no, we, well, I don't think, I think Andorra's too far over. There's a road through the west side, because we already did the Andorra road the way down.
We did this.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much it. But there's a route here.
Yeah.
So go to page 76. Let's have a look. Andorra will take us too far over. Yeah, so there's a road. Here we go, 75, 76. Okay, Bordeaux, right, here we go, right? Pamplona, I think there's this road here. So what we do, we can do a quick Google, yeah?
You wanted to go through here, didn't you? The Pyrenees, through here.
Yeah, the Pyrenees there. Where's Andorra? Still miles over there, you see?
Yeah, yeah. That's fine, isn't it?
Yeah, we can do one of these roads. So there was a road, it's called that N...
Well, basically, we can have a look tonight, because we ain't going to reach there anyway.
Yeah, we'll have a look tonight.
So you want to head towards... what?
Basically, yeah, we... what's that? Yeah? Yeah, the Pyrenees, yeah? It's basically, if we go from here, we do something like that, yeah, up there. But we just need to work out exactly which road it is that goes through there, and so we do want to head this way. We don't want to go too far that way. Yeah, we want to try and San Sebastian should be the, yeah, or Pamplona is not a bad place for us to go to. That will then take us through the Pyrenees.
Instead of going there, we just go up a bit.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, we don't need to go that far across.
Yeah, it's probably, I think that's probably the right route anyway.
Yeah, and then we can go north from there.
Pamploma.
Yeah, Pamploma. Yeah, yeah,
we are,
yeah.
We are going that way.
Yeah, that's where we want to go.
Yeah.
Then we just go north instead of going into Andorra, because we already did that side. But we'll find a nice route tonight.
So we just go to Pamplona?
Yeah, let's go Pamplona for now.
Head towards the Pamplona.
Yeah. How far is that?
Far.
Huh? Quite far. Yeah, but we'll have a stopover, won't we?
Yeah, we'll have to have a stop tonight, yeah. Let's do a new route then.
Just avoid the tolls, yeah? For now. Let's bang out some more today. And then we'll see where we are tomorrow. Alright, so that's where we're heading. Then we'll make a route tomorrow. Tonight, have a little chat, and then I'll Google some good routes north west side of the Pyrenees, yeah, Spanish side or the French side, see which is the best way up. I do recall Pamplona being a location from kind of where the you can catch a road going north. Just have to work out how far into Pyrenees we want to go. Later.
We're meant to be going on the motorway now. So unless this is a slip road, must be taking us up to that bridge, is it? Yeah, I think it is. Yeah, must be. There'll be a shortcut there. Right. don't know if it's a two-way road or a one-way road. Been for another kilometre, 20 miles per hour, up on the curb. Okay, just going to this town, it's getting late now, it's 26, 4 degrees, 263 miles down, and yeah, just what the buildings in this little town. Let's find a hotel. Otherwise we'll be driving aimlessly. Which one? Wallavant? We're having fucking a Wallavant. Okay. How far is it? Okay. Should we find a hotel now or you want to find one when we get there? Okay. Yeah, this is Livradois-Forez. I think it's quite a place of historical culture. That's already... Oh my gosh, it's got angry culture. Ooh, what the fuck? I'm going to be comfy with all of this. Okay. Yeah, go and have a look. We'll have a look at it. See how much it costs.
Seven miles, yeah.
How many? 7 miles. Alright, let's see if we stand on this estate a bit more. At the moment we're pretty knackered at the street, we can't really find it looking for it.
I'm just gonna. So Jazzy's Garmin brought us here. We just went inside. Ask about this place. It does say Hotel Club Boutique on the side as well, by the way. Hotel Club Boutique. Yeah, so we were having a look at this hotel. It's a bit nippy. And went inside, it's really plush and it was really warm in there. And we said to him, how much is a twin room? And the guy just looked at us and he sort of goes, and we went, ah, all right, it's a knocking shop. All right, Daz is unloading, as you can see. So off we go on our adventure to go find another hotel up the road. Alright, we've turned up. Forgot, what's this place called? I've forgotten already.
Medina
something or other. It's quite nice, big square in the middle. We're trying to find some food.
Mecca Medina,
isn't it? Oh yeah, I did pick a nice restaurant, but Jazzy's overruling it at the moment. We're looking for a pizza place.
Yeah, it's
you can't get enough pizza. Yeah.
Saw some lesbians in there, he just wants to go in there for some reason. Don't understand this guy.
How does he know that?
Spotted
him
up. I'm
either way. He just ruined my video.
Good.
Some sort of protest going on by the truckers. Yeah, I think there's a load of truckers down there. So we've got the map out. All right, we are. Medina del Campo. So we're now gonna go sort of this route here, 122, up to here, Aria, yeah? And then from there, we're gonna try and sort of go through these mountains up here. We wanna end up about here, Olite, where there's a monastery built into the hills. And then after that, there's a gorge, two gorges. So we're gonna try and hit the gorges, and that'll get us into Pamplo. Yeah, which is like, you know, it's a 5-hour drive altogether, so we're just gonna see how far we can get. Mad number of truckers, man. Hey?
I hope we ain't going that way.
I think we might be going that way. And it's already started raining. We haven't even set off this morning. So, lovely jubbly. Catch you later. Thank you.
here we are, this is the truckers demonstration that's going on. I think we're going to go down that road as well, not sure. Yeah. You alright? We'll overtake them all. Well, no, won't be longer. Won't it be longer? Have a go. Alright, go on, go the other way. Okay, there's all the truckers. We're going to try and get here. We're going to go around them somehow, which I don't think is so easy. There's mainly country lanes here. You go one way and you're kind of stuck going that way for a while. This is obviously not part of the debate. I think that was a tail end of truckers, right? There's 50 plus trucks there. Well, we came here, this magnificent wall all the way along, and a really impressive castle. But yeah, we're changing direction because we're trying to get onto the N221. So that is dangerous direction. Here's this place, look at that wall. And look at that fortified. Imagine what that was once upon a time, hey? And that is this little town again. It's got some very impressive sort of, I don't know, it's a Roman, but, got some very impressive buildings. Yeah, it must have been a grandiose old town back in the day. Yeah, look at that. And look at that wall. Look at that. Yeah, and it's not small, is it? Not a small place, is it? I've got a heron nesting right in the top of that one, in one of the towers. Yeah, like I said, nice little town. What's up, bro?
I need a coffee.
It's like this the other day, guys. Aren't we going on the M221? Matt? Let's just stop for a second. Turn around. Yeah. Let's turn it over there. Have a quick look at the map. Let's just pop up there. Come here.
Yeah, we're a bit cold this morning, a bit frozen, making really slow progress. Wind is mad, we're getting blown all around earlier on. I think they blocked the road off where we wanted to go as well, which doesn't really help. So we could probably get the bike through. We'll crack on. We're not going to get there till 5 o'clock without stopping. So we need to stop, but I've had to plug in the heated jacket. Jazz has got the heated gloves. It's cold. Okay, right, see you soon.
I'm only 2 miles down though. Jason's bike uses more fuel than mine. And mine has a bigger pack, I think, as well. I think it's a little bit further up, so I can get in there.
Okay, we're in Soria at Lidl's. Quite a long ride down. Have a look at that sign over there. We came along the 122 N122 looking for somewhere to eat. Where are we going?
Go with the flow.
No, you pick somewhere now. Here.
I ain't picking nothing.
No. Come here. Right, so this is it now. Look. So today, I thought I'd feed him lunch, make a nice change.
Oh, you're paying, eh?
He's allowed lunch today. Normally he doesn't even get fed lunch.
Or breakfast.
No, I gave him breakfast today. I fed him breakfast. Because he missed breakfast.
Fed him breakfast. It's like he's paid for all of these breakfasts and lunches.
Right, there's Burger King.
No.
There's La Tesquita El Lago, 4.4. Let's have a look at that. Oh, okay, now I know how H feels. I'm H3. And I hate H1 feels. So you don't like the look of any of that. Dal Roti. Right?
Oh, it's salad.
Yeah, they're all going to have salad.
Yeah,
right. Yeah? Salad. Hang on.
Salad and chips, mate.
So this is 4.4. The other one was 4.3. And if we go anywhere else, it's in town. So what we do, so we're here, Lidl's, we can go down.
We need to go that way anyway.
If we go down there, second left, yeah, take the second left, and you'll see La Tesquita El Lago.
Right, so here we are in a cafe. Yeah, go and grab some. Yeah, just getting some food in.
Gracias.
He didn't listen, did he?
Yeah?
Didn't listen, did he?
What's that?
Gave us two the same. Wanted one with ham and one with cheese, but we got the same.
Want some peppers?
Huh?
Want some peppers?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know how we're going to cut it all up. Wasn't there no knife or anything, have we?
Huh?
Was there no knife or anything?
I didn't see any. Oh, fuck. I'll take one back.
Let's find a hotel. Right, we'll work out the hotel bit. And just saving yourself for some pizza later. King of the pizza. Right, first we've got to see how much this is going to cost us.
Thank you.
is nice, isn't it? Yeah. We work. Work. All right.
All right. View from my hotel. Right, I'm going to have to move the bikes before 8 o'clock. Look how many birds there are here. Huh? Yeah, I'm moving the bikes before 8. Huh? And come back and have brekkie.